I was worried when the Grebes lost that second game. But after we won games 3 and 4, I knew the hat was still working.
Look, it's Teddy's new commercial, and I'm in it.
Come on down to Crosswire Motors for a...
Is your dad wearing a Grebes hat?
Remember, at Crosswire Motors, you'll always drive away a winner.
Go Grebes!
That is so hypocritical. You and your dad have always been Kings fans.
Yeah, but now the Grebes have 3 wins. It's much more fun to be on the winning side.
Anybody can root for a winning team. It takes character to stick with the underdogs.
Well, Buster, tonight's the night.
Yep, tomorrow the Grebes could be the world champions.
Yeah!
And the Kings have taken game 5, forcing a 6th game.
Don't worry, we're still up 3-2.
Oh, Daddy, this is terrible. What'll we do if they don't win the next one?
Don't worry, Muffin. We can always pull the new Grebes commercial off the air and replace it with the Kings one.
I just hope the curse hasn't kicked in.
Are you going to the game with Harry tonight?
Yeah, and I really want to see us win. So far, I've only been there when we lose.
Oh, really? How interesting.
It's just, you know, now that I think about it...
A strange coincidence?
Okay, well, gotta go.
This could be it. The Grebes can finally win it all. Just 1 out away from the world championship. Here's the pitch. It's an easy grounder to Ivo Schachter. It went right through his legs. The Grebes just lost their best chance to win it all again.
When I show up, they lose. When I'm not there, they win. Oh, I'm their biggest fan, but what if... What if...
There he is! Get him! Ah! That way!
Hey, hold it right there.
Is this that kid with the curse?
Sí, ese es.
You're the reason the Grebes are losing!
You don't think I'd curse the team I love, do you?
You're bad luck.
Get out of town, Baxter. Lárgate.
You've done enough damage!
What are you doing here? You don't even believe in the curse.
Of course not. But according to the quantum theory, the outcome of any experiment is partly determined by the presence of a particular observer.
What does that have to do with baseball?
Your very presence in the stands has a negative impact on the physics of baseball for the Grebes.
In other words, you're the curse.
No! I can't go to the last game. I just can't.
Do you want one of those to wear to the big game tomorrow?
Mom, I want you to take my ticket. I can watch the game on TV.
Oh, that is so sweet of you. But you and Harry are diehard fans. You've got to be there for the final game of the World Championship. We forgot the milk. Will you run and get it?
Sure. Playman?
Hey, kid.
Wow, this is... I'm a big fan.
Nice to meet you.
Would you sign my milk carton?
Sure. What's your name?
Buster Baxter.
Hey, Playman. There's a special on apples.
Winland? Batteria? You guys buy groceries, too?
This is Buster. How about signing this for him?
We really appreciate your support. We couldn't do it without fans like you.
You going to the big game?
Yes. I mean, no. Trust me, you don't want me there.
Why no?
You know how you lost games 2, 5, and 6? It was my fault.
Guess we're off the hook.
No, it's true. When I'm in the stands, you lose. When I'm not, you win. It's the curse. I bring the curse.
No, es verdad. It's not true.
The curse is you not showing up for the game because you're afraid we'll lose.
The curse is you thinking that we don't need you in the stands tomorrow. Because the fact is, we do. Ever hear of Dickinson?
Shortstop?
Poet. Lived in New England. Wrote a poem that goes like this. Hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without the words and never stops at all.
Do you see what we're trying to say?
Not really.
Tomorrow at the big game, hope is a green-tailed grebe. If we're gonna win...
Then we need all the fan support we can get.
We need you, Buster. Curse or no curse.
Yeah, Buster, we need you.
It's the bottom of the ninth. The bases are loaded for the Grebes, but they're down 10-7 and have two outs against them.
I think it's time.
Playman is up.
Strike one.
Come on, Playman.
Strike two.
Hope is the thing with feathers!
Woohoo! Oh no! Buster's cracking!
Oh, I can't watch!
Playman connects! This ball is hit hard! It could be enough! Off the foul pole! It's fair! Graves win!
Yay! Playman's the best!
The numbers were right!
We're the world champions! And it only took 87 years!
And you can tell your grandchildren you were there!
The most amazing part was what happened to the ball after Playman hit it. It went up and up, and then it sprouted feathers.
Wings! Did anyone ever find that ball?
Oh, no. It flapped right out of the ballpark, past the moon, and right to the stars.